In this session, we are going to discuss two types of data objects, that is atoms and numbers. So let us go for further details. First, let us start with atoms. So atoms can be constructed in mainly three different ways. The string of letters, digits and the underscore character starting with a lowercase letter will be known as an atom. As an example, you can go for this. So here you see, here we are having this set of atoms. So all of them are having either some digits, underscore characters and alphabets in the lowercase. Okay. So strings of special characters can also be treated as an atom. So these are the string of special characters. So they will be also treated as atoms. When using atoms of this form, some care is necessary because some strings of special characters already have a predefined meaning. As example, colon dash, it indicates if. So in our prolog clause writing, we always go for this colon dash. It indicates if. So this colon dash cannot be used as an atom because it is predefined. Strings of characters enclosed in single quotes can also be treated as atoms. For example, to have an atom that starts with a capital letter. We know that whenever we usually start something with a capital letter, that will be denoted by a variable. So variable comes with the first letter in capital. So in those cases, if I want to make one atom with the first letter capital, like your this Rubai, say Arindam Chatterjee, say Sumit Mitra, in this case, if you write them as the first letters are capitals, but I do not want to mention them as a variable but as atoms, then they must be enclosed within single quotes, and that is a nice way to represent atoms here. So now let us go for the numbers. So integer numbers can be represented as 100, 4, minus 87, 1020, that is 1020. The normal range of integer numbers will be this. This is a normal range in which we can express our integer numbers. The treatment of real numbers depends on the implementation of the prolog, and the version of the prolog will decide that one. Examples are this, this, this are the respective examples of the real numbers. But real numbers are not used very much in typical prolog programming, as prolog is primarily a language for symbolic and non-numeric computation. In symbolic computation, integers are often used, for example, to count the number of items in list, but there is a little need of these real numbers. So that's why how to express this integer numbers, real numbers, we have discussed that one. And prior to that, we have shown you that how to represent atoms mainly into three different ways. Thanks for watching this video.